Hello everyone. So let's continue where we left the fourth lecture of flow through pipes. Okay. So up till now we have seen the major loss in pipe, minor loss in pipe, expression of head due to major loss, that is friction in pipe. We have derived it and it comes out to be HF is equal to FL V square upon 2GD. Then we have seen the definition of hydraulic grid line, total energy line. And then we have derived some cases for minor losses, that is loss of head due to sudden enlargement. And what is the value? HE is equal to V1 minus V2 square upon 2G. And also we have seen the loss of head due to sudden contraction. We have the value for it as 0.5 V2 square upon 2G when the CC is not given. Okay. So let's continue. Now we are going to see flow through pipes in series, okay, or flow through compound pipes. So when we have multiple pipes, more than two pipes in series, we have to find out the head loss in those pipes, total head loss. So suppose we have reservoir A and reservoir B. So what will be the total head loss once the water starts flowing from A to B in these three pipes? We have three pipes, pipe 1, pipe 2 and pipe 3. Okay, so what will be the total head loss here? Let's start from this point. Okay, this here. So the head loss will be first here at minor losses. Let's count the minor losses here. The first head loss will be there at the entrance of the pipe. Second head loss here will be head loss due to contraction of diameter. You can see in this diagram that the pipe is getting contracted. The diameter is getting contracted. Third head loss is due to sudden enlargement. And fourth head loss is head loss due to exit, right? At the exit of the pipe. So these are the 1, 2, 3, 4 are the minor losses. And also there are respective major losses in pipe 1, pipe 2 and pipe 3. So what are the total, what is the total head loss in this system? We have to find out that. Okay. So the total loss of head will be equal to minor losses plus major losses. All this is given. You can refer to my slides afterwards. The L1, L2, L3 are length, D1, D2, D3, diameter, velocity, coefficient of friction, and H is difference of water level in two tanks, right? So there is level difference. That's why the flow is taking place, and that level difference is H. Now the discharge through all the pipes 1, 2, 3 respectively will be the same, Q. So we are going to apply the continuity equation, and we have Q is equal to A1 V1 is equal to A2 V2 and is equal to A3 V3. And also the total loss of head will be equal to sum of minor losses plus major losses. Okay. So let's see. What is that? So the major loss will be HF1 plus HF2 plus HF3. While the minor loss will be, as I said earlier, first will be loss at the entrance. Second is loss due to sudden contraction. Third is loss due to sudden enlargement. And fourth, loss at the exit of pipe. So these are the minor losses. So total head loss will be sum of these two, major loss and minor loss. And if the minor loss is neglected, we'll have the total head loss as sum of the major losses. So here they have taken just 1 by 2G common, and we have the total head loss H, right? The head loss H will be equal to 1 by 2G into F1 L1 V1 square upon D1 plus F2 L2 V2 square upon D2. plus F3 L3 V3 square upon D3. Okay, that is the total head loss. Now, like you can see here, this is the total head difference. The flow is taking place due to this head loss, and this its value is sum of minor losses plus major losses. Okay, so let's move ahead. We'll see equivalent pipe or Dupuit's equation. This question comes in exam for 5 to 6 marks, and it is very easy. It will either the exam will have this derivation or it will have a numerical based on this equation. So what is Dupuit's equation or equivalent pipe? Like the name suggests, equivalent pipe means we are having only one uniform pipe instead of compound pipes, several number of pipes. Okay, so this equivalent pipe will have uniform diameter, single diameter, instead of compound pipes consisting of several pipes of different lengths and diameters. Okay, so let's see the diagram. So this three pipes, there are three pipes, L1, L2 and L3 lengths, and D1, D2, D3 diameters. But instead of all these three pipes, I just replace this whole system with a singular pipe having one diameter, but same diameter, but head loss in this pipe is equivalent to head loss in this three pipes, sum of head loss in these three pipes, that is equivalent pipe. So let's derive the Dupuit's equation. Okay, so let the length of pipe 1, 2, 3 will be L1 L2 L3, and diameter will be D1 D2 D3 as the previous diagram suggests. Okay, H is the total head loss and L is the equivalent length of the equivalent pipe, and diameter of these diameter of the equivalent pipe. So now the total length will be what? The total length will be what? It will be equal to L1, L2. Wait a second. It will be, total length will be what? L1 plus L2 plus L3. Okay. This will be the total length. L1 plus L2 plus L3. Okay. So this is my equivalent length. And the diameter, what is the equivalent diameter? That we have to find out in this Dupuit's equation. So let's first find out the total head loss, which we have already found out actually. So it is HF1, HF2, HF1 plus HF2 plus HF3, right? The head loss is HF1 plus HF2 plus HF3. Now we put the values of discharge, the velocities in this equation. So discharge Q is equal to A1 V1 is equal to A2 V2 is equal to A3 V3 in these three pipes. And also assuming that all the friction factors are same, what we do? We just put the value for V1 square, V2 square and V3 square. Okay. So Q is equal to V1 pi by 4 D1 square. So V1 will be equal to what? 4Q upon pi D1 square. So we put this value here in this equation of head loss, and then we further simplify. Okay. So what is the total head loss now? Total head loss will be what? We are taking out few terms common, that is Q square, this Q square, 16. Friction factor F is same. We have assumed F is equal to F1, F2, F3. And in the denominator, we are taking out what else we have common? Pi square. Then 2g. Okay, all these things we have taken common, and we have now the equation for total head loss will be equal to h is equal to 16 fq square upon pi square 2g into l1 upon d1 raised to 5. See, here it has 2 power, d1 square and again there is square. So d1 raised to 4, and here we have one more d1. So we'll have d1 raised to 5 in the denominator. So this is the equation for total head loss. Okay. Now, if instead of these three pipes, I have a single equivalent pipe which has single diameter and one length, whole length having a same diameter, I have head loss h is equal to what? FL v square upon 2gd. We are assuming that instead of three pipes, I have a single pipe of length L1 plus L2 plus L3 and whose diameter, equivalent diameter, is d. Okay. So what we'll have now as head loss, it will be h is equal to FL v square upon 2gd, and v is the velocity in that pipe, the uniform velocity which we are having in that singular pipe instead of three pipes. Okay. So let's put the value v is equal to q by a, that is equal to 4q by pi d square. Now the head loss in the equivalent pipe, the head loss in the equivalent pipe and the head loss in the compound pipe are same, right? That is, we have one common value of head loss, that is equal to h, right? So let's, head loss in compound pipe and equivalent pipe is same. Hence, equating this equation and the equation we have derived previously, this equation we have derived, right? Previously, wait a second. Yes, this equation we have derived previously. This equation and this equation we are equating, and what we have now, all these terms are common, so they will get cancelled. 16 fq square upon pi square by 2g. So we have l raised to d5, d raised to 5, l upon d raised to 5 equivalent to l1 upon d1 raised to 5 plus L2 upon D2 raised to 5 plus L3 upon D3 raised to 5. This is the Dupuytren's equation. So what we are doing in short is that we are replacing compound pipes. Compound pipes means two or more pipes with a single pipe having length, sum of length of those compound pipes having L length is equal to L1 plus L2 plus L3, and diameter also equivalent, singular diameter of that equivalent pipe, which we will find out from this equation, right? Now from this equation, we know L1, L2 and L3. Also we know L, which is having value, which is having value the sum of these three, right? And we know D1, D2, D3, right? So from this, we can find out the equivalent diameter of pipe. So at any place, instead of having pipes of three different diameters, we can have a singular pipe having diameter d, having length l, which is equivalent to l1 plus l2 plus l3, and head loss is same. Head loss is same in this one pipe and in these three pipes. Okay, so this is the Dupuytren's equation. So either you will have a numerical on this or you will have this derivation itself. Okay, let's move ahead. Flow through parallel pipes. Okay, now we have seen the flow through series. Now we'll see flow in parallel. So how is the flow in parallel? The pipes, the Q discharge, singular discharge is getting split in Q2 and Q1, right? the singular discharge is getting split into Q1 and Q2. So the main equation we have from this is Q is equal to Q1 plus Q2, right? The pipes are in parallel. First, we saw the pipes in series. Now we are seeing the pipes in parallel. So what is happening is the pipes are branching. Now here in this diagram, we have only two branches, but it may have pipes in parallel may have two or more branches. Okay, so like if Q is flowing in this direction and then it is branching in several directions, and again they are going to meet at some place. Right? So these are the pipes in parallel. Okay. So consider main pipe which divides into two or more branches and join. It is again joined in the downstream. Okay. So discharge Q remains constant. So Q is equal to Q1 plus Q2. Now in this arrangement, the loss of head will be same, right? The loss of head will be same because the pipes are getting together again in the downstream. Okay. So head loss is same. So we have two equations. One is what? Q is equal to Q1 plus Q2, and other is head loss in pipe 1 is equal to head loss in pipe 2. Correct? Head loss in pipe 1 is head loss in pipe 2, or branch pipe you may call it as. Okay? So what we have now, the equation F1 L1 V1 square is equal to 2GD1 upon 2GD1 is equal to F2 L2 V2 square upon 2GD2. Okay, so assuming F friction factor are the same, we have L1 V1 square upon 2GD1 is equal to L2 V2 square upon 2GD2. It's simple, right? So today we have learned three things. One is flow through pipes in series or flow through compound pipes. Second, equivalent pipe or Dupuytren's equation. And third, flow through parallel pipes. We'll continue in the next class. Till then, you just go through my PPTs 1, which I'll share you on the Google Classroom. Okay. Right. Okay. Bye bye.